Hello, Thomas Malchow here. I know I keep saying this, but this video has me really excited. Ryan would like to know what is the best type of cardio to do for golf. This is such a great question and a very interesting topic. Let me preface our conversation we're going to have here by saying whatever activities you enjoy doing, I would encourage you to keep doing those. The last thing we want to do is exclude activities. When it comes to general health, the more active you are, the better. Okay, so remember that as we dive into this, because what we're going to talk about here is for those who are looking to exploit every corner of their biology for the purpose of becoming better at golf, because the activities we would choose for performance might be different than the activities we would choose for general health. The performance stuff is all healthy, but not all of the general health stuff is going to be great for golf, because to improve your performance, you have to pick activities that are going to increase your capacity to practice more while training and developing the energy systems specific to the sport. What do I mean by energy systems? Well, your body needs energy to function. Everybody knows that, right? But where does your body get this energy from? Well, it gets it from the food that you eat. We're going to talk more about nutrition and how it affects your performance in future videos. We'll put that aside for now. But your body takes the food that you eat and breaks it down into various components. It then takes those components and converts them into a high energy compound called adenosine triphosphate, or ATP. It then takes that ATP and stores it in your muscle cells. Every time your muscles contract, they use up some of that ATP supply, which means your body must always replenish its ATP supply. Now, how does it do that? Well, your body has three different energy systems that it can choose from to replenish its ATP supply. There's the anaerobic alactic system, there's the anaerobic lactic system, and the aerobic system. Okay? Which system your body chooses, or systems, is going to depend on what type of activity we're doing. Again, we're here talking about golf, and golf is comprised of two activities. One, the swing, and two, walking. Now, with respect to the swing, we can impose the biggest impact by getting you more distance off the tee and more precision into your putting. So knowing those two things, we can then ascertain which energy systems to choose from by determining what the limiting factors are. That is, what's keeping you from getting that distance and that precision. Well, if we dive a little deeper, we find that the limiting factors to golf are power, mental concentration, and aerobic endurance. Aerobic endurance might not seem as important as in other sports. However, the average golfer walks between 4 and 5 miles per round. And so fatigue can impact your performance, especially in the later holes. Now, the swing for the power to get more distance off the tee, that is 100% anaerobic, right? But which anaerobic system? Is it the anaerobic alactic system or the anaerobic lactic system? Well, it's the anaerobic alactic system. This is the energy system used for any movement that is very short and powerful, lasting less than 8 seconds, like when you use your driver. Okay, so we want to train and develop the anaerobic alactic system as well as the aerobic system. Again, your ability to have precise putting is going to hinge on you being able to focus, right? Having good aerobic endurance is going to help you cope with fatigue and improve your concentration and effectiveness, especially in those later holes. Okay, so let's start with the anaerobic alactic system. To train and develop this system, we want to choose reps that are very short and powerful, very explosive, lasting less than 8 seconds. And the effort level has to be at 95% or higher, meaning you have to go all out, okay? And you must not go more than 8 seconds. If you go longer than 8 seconds, you're going to use up all of your creatine phosphate. Creatine phosphate is the fuel for the anaerobic alactic system. And if you run out of fuel for that energy system, you're going to slip into the anaerobic lactic system, which is not the energy system used in golf, and so we don't want to waste our time training and developing it, right? As a point of interest, a byproduct of the anaerobic lactic system is lactic acid. That's why it's called the lactic system. Lactic acid is the burning that you feel in your muscles when you're working out. So when you're training, if you feel burning, if you feel that lactic acid, that is a clear indication that you are in the wrong energy system. So in that case, stop, take a rest, 3 minutes rest, allow your creatine phosphate to replenish and stay in that anaerobic alactic system, okay? So I'm going to show you three things here, three exercises that are focused on training and developing your anaerobic alactic system, and then I'll show you some things to do for the aerobic system as well. So the first exercise I'm going to show you to train and develop your anaerobic alactic system is called the scissor jump. Now, the scissor jump is also a plyometric exercise, which means it's comprised of three phases: the eccentric phase, the amortization phase, and the concentric phase. So I'll show you the setup here first, and I'll explain the phases after. So the setup is just in the lunge position here like this. Okay, so I have my feet are hip width apart, so I'm not walking a tightrope. I have my feet under my hips. I just take a step forward, and I have a wide enough step so that I can bend my knees comfortably, okay? Now, the eccentric phase of this jump is going to be as I lower my body, right? Doing this loads my tissues with elastic energy, okay? Which I'm going to recover to jump and switch my legs. Now, the key is not to hang out too long at the bottom. So if I go like this and then I hang out here, I've loaded my tissues with elastic energy, but because I've hung out here too long, my muscles just reabsorb that energy and I've lost it. So we want to transition from the eccentric to the concentric as fast as possible. That amortization phase, that period between eccentric and concentric, the shorter that transition, the more energy you will recover and the more explosive your tissues will become. Okay? So I'll show you the wrong way first. We don't want to do this. Because I'm absorbing all of that energy. I want to transition at the bottom as quickly as possible. Okay? So I'm going to do 8 repetitions, transitioning as fast as possible between eccentric to concentric. Okay, I would do 1 to 3 sets. If I'm doing more than one set, I rest three full minutes to allow my creatine phosphate to replenish so that I stay in that anaerobic alactic system. The next exercise I'm going to show you here is called the jump squat. It's very similar to the scissor jump, where it is a plyometric exercise. We don't want to hang out at the bottom too long. We want to transition from eccentric to concentric as quickly as possible. So instead of being in a lunge position, we'll be in the squat position, okay? So we would start here, and we have 2 different ways we can do this, depending on your fitness level. If you're very fit, what you can do is you just transition from one jump to the next very quickly and repeatedly. So we would go like this. Right? You could also regress that and pause in between. So jump, take a moment. Either way, there's a couple things to be aware of. We do not want your feet to turn out. As you squat, you don't want this to happen. You don't want this to happen. You want your feet directly under your hips, second toes pointing straight ahead, and we don't let the knees cave in or go out trying to bring the knees tracking right over your feet. Okay? Another thing is we don't want you leaning forward too much. We would like to keep the angle between your tibia and your torso somewhat parallel. It's going to be very difficult for you to see that, so don't worry about that too much right now. Okay, so again, I'll show you here. Whew. Again, 1 to 3 sets. If you do more than one set, rest full 3 minutes. Okay, so the last exercise we're gonna do for your anaerobic alactic system is the lateral jump to stabilization. It's a plyometric off of one leg and a stabilization on the other. So we're jumping off of one leg laterally, landing and stabilizing for 3 seconds on the other leg before returning back the other direction. Okay, so it looks like this. And again, 16 reps total because we're doing 8 on each side. If you're going to do more than one set, rest 3 minutes. Again, keeping that amortization phase very quick. Okay, so now onto the aerobic system. To train and develop your aerobic system, we want to pick an activity or activities that last anywhere from 10 minutes to 2 hours and are done at a steady pace. So if you're checking heart rate, we're looking at 70 to 80% of your maximum heart rate. Now, the activities you choose are extremely important. We do not want to pick any activities that pull capacity out of your body. Every tissue in your body has a capacity. And what I mean by that is how much that tissue can endure before it becomes injured. Say over a workout, a round of golf, a tournament, a month, 6 months, a year, etc. Everything you do is either putting capacity into your body or taking capacity out of your body. Capacity is a commodity and there's a limit to it. It's like money. The purpose of your workouts should be to fill your body full of capacity so you can then take that capacity and spend it on the golf course. Swinging a golf club is hard on your body. It uses up a lot of your capacity. If your workouts are also using up your capacity, that is not a recipe for success. And in fact, it's a wasted opportunity. So given that, for golfers, I recommend 3 20-minute walks every day. One in the morning, one at midday, and one in the late afternoon or early evening. These walks should be done at a brisk pace. Move those arms a lot. And again, if you're checking heart rate, you're looking for 70 to 80% of your maximum heart rate. I also want you to supplement that walking with carefully organized routines that are designed to create balance in your body. These are the corrective exercise routines we've talked about in previous videos that target your muscle imbalances. Muscle imbalances create movement inefficiencies. Those movement inefficiencies cause you to have to compensate. And guess what? Compensating uses up a ton of capacity. By fixing your muscle imbalances, you can increase your neuromuscular control and dramatically increase your capacity. Also, take a look at your nutrition and your sleep. A lot of people say they want to be and play their best, but few people do what it takes to get there. If you want to be your best and reach your full potential, you have to live a high-performance lifestyle. And that includes eating healthy food and getting good sleep. You need to have the energy and the focus to have productive practice. If you want to reach your full potential, you have to have the capacity to practice more. There's no shortcuts. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you for watching.